The challenger today, Rich Hawk Halas of Chelsea. Hi, everybody. Welcome once again to Candlepin Bowling. I'm Don Gillis, and you all know by now that this program is on videotape. We do our taping right here at Sammy White's Brighton Bowl, and we do it sometimes several weeks in advance of the time you actually see the telecast. It is always three strings of candlepin bowling. It is total pinfall which will determine our winner. That winner is rewarded with a handsome marble-based trophy from the Ace Trophy Company of Boston. The runner-up receives a smaller but otherwise identical version indicating he was a participant on our show. Now, guaranteed prize money is $1,150. $700 of that goes to the winner. $300 goes to the runner-up. There's $50 available for the winner of each string. Obviously, should they tie a string in any particular string, then we would split that $25 apiece. Now, for a 400 series, there's an extra bonus of $100. For three marks in a row, that's any combination of strikes or spares in the same string, $50 in bonus money. Then each subsequent consecutive mark in that same string would be worth $50 each, just as long as he can keep it going. Our 1-7-10 high-low jackpot is now at $125. Our home viewer jackpot is at $450. And, of course, the big prize, which Charlie Jutras hit last week, for three strikes in a row, it's an additional bonus of $1,000. And each subsequent consecutive strike after those three would be worth $1,000 each. Okay, that's it. Let's get underway, shall we? Right after this. All right, leading off, today's challenger, Rich Hawk Halas, Chelsea. This is the fourth time that Rich has been on our show, and he's still looking for his first win. Excuse me. I'll give you his stats. He has a league average of 127. Starts off with a nine box. His high single is 184, his high triple 486. He had a 641 winning his roll-off. Rich is married. He works as a head receiver for Sam Hartstein and Sons. Representing the Malden Square Bowlodrome. No, that looked pretty good as he released it. Pair of nines. Now our defending champion, Charlie Jutras. Charlie had quite a day last week, won his title, but in addition, won himself a lot of money, had three strikes in a row, that close. And we've seen nothing but nine so far. Charlie rolled a 395 last week in beating Steve Badney. In addition to winning the $1,000 for three strikes in a row, Charlie also won a trip for two to Singapore, courtesy Singapore Airlines. And a week at the Singapore Mandarin Hotel. And if you're wondering why we're not mentioning that again, well, that was our agreement with Singapore Airlines. They would supply us with two sets of trips for two plus 1 week. And I guess in the first time in my 26 years of being on this show, we had people hit three strikes in a row in about the shortest span. So that took care of it for this season. Okay, here's Hawk Halas. He was really accurate on hitting the object pin, but he didn't get the desired effect. And he has another nine. Just missed the head pin. Right in on the two. And it appears he may have his fourth consecutive nine. And that's what it is. Now Charlie Jutras. Last week, Charlie started off like a house of fire. By the time he had five marks, he was up around 100 and something then. Talk about slow motion. Ralph Stewart calls time. He wants to go down there and just take a look at that piece of wood, see whether it is... Okay, it is behind the deadwood line, which means it could be used by Charlie if he chose to, but he'll go right after this and miss it. Charlie's league average right now is 125. His high single is 203 and his high triple 485. And he had a great roll-off, a 709 for the five-string roll-off. As you probably, many of you know, Charlie is a professional, not to be confused with commercial, fisherman. He's a professional bass fisherman, which means you enter tournaments and you try to have, in the 2 or 3 days, whatever the tournament lasts, more poundage caught bass than any of the others who are competing. Okay, the end of four, the score. One pin lead in the match right now for Charlie Jutras. He's at 37, Rich Halas at 36. Our challenger today, Rich Halas. Rich's first appearance on our show, he rolled a 361, but that was not good enough to defeat Danny Murphy. Second time on, he rolled a 353, but lost to Pete Iannuzzo. And then, his last time, he rolled a 359 and was defeated by Paul Daugherty. So he has rolled very well while he's been on, but is still looking for that elusive first win. Just missed to the right that time, whereas the last time, it was the opposite. Okay, there's a 10. After a string of five nines. Charlie Jutras. We're still looking for the first mark today. By this time last week, Charlie had already Well, let's see. He had one more frame to go. And the fifth was when he got his third strike. Charlie, with the start he had last week, looked as if he was going to be a cinch to take over first place for our championship show, but he is in fourth place, having rolled a 395. Paul Berger is in fifth place with a 392. Nope. Rich Pedroli's 415 still leads it. John Miller's 412 is second, and Steve Adney's 405 is third. Right now, Tim Lipke's 374 would be the alternate, but that probably won't last too much longer. But Tim had himself the great year last year and won our last championship show. Hawk Halas. Has to settle for an eight. $125 in our high-low jackpot, $450 in the home viewer jackpot, and I tell you, that barrel is pretty full right now. Gonna be tough to convert that. I keep referring to the fact that Charlie had such a great start last week, and he had an interesting remark at the end of the program when I said, "You started off like a house of fire. What happened?" He said, "I woke up." And that, as we were talking after the show, is in a sense what happened. I mean, he just came in here so relaxed, so loose. Everything, ball was going exactly where he wanted. And then when he got that far ahead, he started thinking about our championship show and the fact that he had an excellent opportunity to load up. And then he started to concentrate on maybe steering the ball a little bit. Let's see what he may try to do with this. Wood is adjacent. Well, it seems to be just touching the six pin. I'm not sure. He'll probably go to the left-hand side of that four pin and see if he can push everything over. Let's see if he does. Yep, that's what he's going to try to do. Nope. Okay, we're not breaking any records here on this string for either bowler. This is Rich Halas. Oh, what a tough lead with that five in there. Time call. Ralph Stewart wants time. I'll remind you again that the big scoreboard, Al Giglio is keeping score on the big scoreboard today. Keith Williams is keeping score beside me. Joanne Panto, as usual, is our statistician and secretary. Ralph Stewart, our lob line judge and referee. And Phil Rubin, the man who puts it all together. That was a good try. What he tried to do, obviously, was get to the right-hand side of the six and get it to move over and try to get the five also. So it's a nine. and an unusual string for Rich Halas because he does not have a mark. No breaks at all. No breaks at all. Well, he's going to, he probably won't hit 90. No, sir. 88. Now, Charlie Jutras. Each bowler has left the door wide open for the other, but neither able to take advantage of it. All right, this can go. It isn't easy by any means, but it can go. He's got the 3 and 6, and he's going to try to move over to get the 7. Let's see if he can do it. No, he had to brush by that 3 and kick it over. One solitary mark so far, and a 5 fill on it. Then Charlie came back with a 5 box, so that nullified that. Three pins wins him $50 for winning the string. Okay, he just did that. Right. Rather enthusiastic cheering. I don't know whether that was literally cheering him for encouragement, or was it a bit of a sarcastic cheer, or what? I don't know. Let's say it was supportive. 6 more. Okay. 104. 102. That's right. 86, and then. All right. He wins $50. Charlie Jutras does, for winning the first string. And there's the story. They both struggled. After one, Jutras 102, Halas 88.
Amy, it's me.
Not that way. Boy, that one got away from him completely. Went off to the right. Didn't come anywhere near the head pin. He almost came back and did it. All right, a 10. Charlie Jutras made his first appearance on our show back in April of 1959. ½ years ago. The diamond wins again, and that reminds me of a very nice letter. And I am grateful to Jane Heffernan, who is the treasurer of the Women's City Candlepin League. Maple Alleys of Brockton. Very nice letter. Appreciate it. And the reason I said it reminded me is, here's Rich Halas, is because she addressed it to Mr. Don, and then in parenthesis, the diamond wins again. Gillis. He did well to get an 8 out of that. Boy, and that was a little bit close to a lob. Well, it was probably maybe a foot or so behind the lob line. Ooh, that hurt. And right on that time. Charlie Jutras has a pair of tens so far in the second string after rolling way below his average first string of 102. Now a single to pick up the 7-pin. Looks good. Okay, he got it. Second, it's only the second mark in the match, both belonging to Charlie Jutras. Both of them spares. Too far right. Six is the fill. Now he has to hit the head pin in order to get everything here. Let's see if he can do it. Yes. All right. Worked out fine as he came in on the head pin, kicked that number two over to the left, and then went down and got the others. All right, Hawk Halas. Not giving up by any means. Bearing down, looking for that elusive first mark. He got it, and it's a beauty. Look at the way he hit that 1-2 and got the 7-10. Oh, what a pretty shot. Now he'll be hoping to come right in on that pocket and get a big 8-9-10. He knew he had it. All right. Well, as we said, he had not given up one iota, and he came right back again and did it. As a result, when we take a little pause here, after four frames in the second string, I can tell you that the score is Charlie Jutras, 46 with a bonus ball to roll. And for Rich Halas, it's 48 with two bonus balls to roll. Charlie Jutras now with a chance for bonus money. He has two marks in a row. Here's the bonus on the second spare. All right, he came back with a strike. $50 more in bonus money. Now he's up there with two strikes in a row again. Last week he did it. Got three in a row. Now he's got a chance to do it again. But let's concentrate now and see what Rich Hawk Halas can do. He's got that strike over there in the fourth. Okay, that's the first bonus ball, and he does have a chance for two if he can now just pick up this 1-2. Oh, too bad. And the ball is, no, it's not going to get it. So the fill is nine, but he wasn't able to convert the spare.
Hello, Ralph.
All right, it's a nine. That was a good hit because he was a little full on the head pin, but there was enough action on the ball because he really has the ball spinning as he lets it go down there. All right. That wasn't the way it was designed, but it went. Now, there it is on the board. You see it. Two strikes in a row for Charlie Jutras. I shall say no more. No. Not three strikes in a row. And he probably will not have another mark here in this street. Oh, he did it! How about that? Out of way, show up Don Gillis, will you? That was a beauty. Look at the way that ball whipped across there to get the 10. Beautifully done. You think I'm going to say he probably won't make this one? Are you crazy? All right, time called again. Ralph Stewart wants to go down there. Except for that single pin in the fifth frame, the one that he left standing, he'd be in great shape right now. This is for bonus money. First ball, didn't get it. Now he's got to do some work if he's going to make this. He was trying to kick the number two over. Just brushed by it. So, no bonus money yet for Rich Hawk Halas. All right, Charlie Jutras right now at 125, two frames to go. Okay, we saw him make this split before. Didn't have exactly the same kind of wood. Can he do it? Didn't get the same action on the ball. A 10 for a 135. He was trying to steer that. He knew it was going to come in too full on the head pin. He was trying to kick it over into the 1-2 pocket with a little body English up here. This could well wind up as a 9 box. Well, an 8 box. 143. Still a chance for Hawk Halas to win the string. Need a couple of marks to do it, and that's a shame. Come right in like that, get rid of the head pin, and look what you wind up with. But that's what makes this game so intriguing, isn't it? The fact that you can come right in on the head pin like that. As I know, we've all said to people who bowl different styles, it ain't as easy as it looks. Or I guess we should say, it's not as easy as these bowlers make it look. Thank you. a 9, and that puts him at 128, which is a fine string, but not enough to catch Charlie Jutras, who wins another $50 for taking the second string. He's now up to $250 in bonus money. And Rich Hawk Halas is still looking for his first bit of bonus money. There's still the third string. The score at the end of two, our defending champion, Charlie Jutras from Feeding Hills, Massachusetts, 245, and his challenger today, Rich Hawk Halas of Chelsea, 216. Rich Halas, our challenger today, leads off the third string. It's Jutras 245 and Halas 216 as we start this third string. Yes, oh yes, made authoritatively. Now the bonus. Eight and a chance, obviously, for another. Oh, that ball just... Now, he's been throwing the ball with that much spin on it all day long, but he's had so much velocity that it has not been breaking. That time, it broke. That's what he wanted to do. But it just was spinning so much, and it was not thrown quite as hard. Probably just took a little tiny bit off, trying to be more accurate, and what happened was that the ball broke. Made a little swerve to the left. The 5 and the 8 to pick up. A little unhappy with himself. This is Charlie's 43rd appearance on our show. That five really didn't want to go for him, did it? I think I said 43. This is 44th appearance, according to these records that I have in front of me, which, of course, Joanne provides for me. Six bucks. So just like that, he loses 12 pins of his lead. There's a spare lead for Rich Halas. He has had some problems with that head pin. That time he got the head pin, but too full. He gave it the good effort, didn't he? And he's too full on the head pin. Well, he took care of one side. Next week, Al Winsick of South Weymouth will be our challenger. 10, and that will be the last of the men's shows for this fall. The women will be on for the next couple of months, and then whomever is the winner of next week's match for the men will be coming back again, but he'll have himself a vacation. Once again, the Spread Eagle. No. Seven. So despite the fact that Rich Halas rolled only a 9-8 the last time he was up, as it turned out, his 17 was all that Charlie Jutras was able to get to, so the lead for Charlie in the match remains 17. And there's a spare for Rich Halas. Put a little more pressure on. Looks good. Yes. Now he's put some pressure right at this moment in unfinished frames for Charlie Jutras. That lead has been cut now down to 7. Now Charlie has a chance to pick up a mark. He had this before, you'll remember, and got just the 8, missed the 5. Went to the right this time. Last time went too far left, and undoubtedly was thinking about that when he delivered the ball. So it's a 10. Hawk has picked up 22 pins. All right, strike against strike. Now we'll see what happens. The lead is 7. All right, let's see what happens. 4 frames to go, and just 7 pins separating our bowlers, each working on a strike right now. Here's Hawk Halas. He's got 2 strikes in a row. As he attempts to come from behind and win this. Also, remember, you know what 3 strikes in a row is worth. Here he goes. He got it. He got it. He got it. 3 strikes in a row for Hawk Halas. $1,000 extra. And the applause for Hawk Halas. And he has just come from behind and has taken the lead, depending upon what Charlie does. All right, Charlie got 7 on the first one. Beauty. A beautiful clutch spare by Charlie Jutras. Wow. All right. Now he's trying to get another mark here. Nope, he's got that same 5-8. And again, the ball went off to the right. Come on, Hawkey. Okay, the Hawk has three strikes in a row up there, and of course that's still alive. He has won $1,000 extra in bonus money. Nope. All right, we saw this made once before by Charlie Jutras. Oh, baby, he really flew that pin over there. Nine. 150. At the split. He's got a... Wait a minute now. This... Hold it, hold it, hold it. Nope, not hard enough. Oh, what a try. What a beautiful try. A 160. Excellent string. Charlie Jutras. Oh, baby, look what he got. No wood to help, no nothing. Oh, baby, have you ever seen a better spare than that in a clutch situation? That is incredible. Oh, what a beautiful, beautiful shot. Oh. We have a new winner. After three unsuccessful tries, Rich Hawk Halas with a sensational 160 closing string has taken it away. And congratulations go to Rich Halas. Because he did it. He came from behind and did it. He also wins the third string, so he winds up with $1,150 in bonus money plus $700 for winning it. $1,850. And he'll get first try at our high-low jackpot, which is now worth $125. Charlie Jutras did not do badly as far as the bonus money was concerned, but he just could not pull it out as Hawk Halas came from behind with a sensational 163rd string. Final score, Hawk Halas 376, Charlie Jutras 362. Look at this son of a gun. It is loaded with cards here. So I sure do hope we have a winner today. $450 is what's in this home viewer jackpot. And the number today is 738. That's the combined total of the 376 and the 362, which our two bowlers have. And again, I'll remind anybody who has not heard of this before, what I'm doing, obviously, is giving the home viewer an opportunity to win some money. And what we ask you to do is submit on a postcard, not a letter, what you think would be the combined total, both bowlers, their combined scores. And if you are within 10 either way, for example, as I said, it's 738 today, that means that anywhere from 728 to 748 would be enough to win the 450. We ask you please to put that on a card and please send it along to this address, which would be Candlepin Bowling, WCVB-TV, 5 TV Place, Needham, Massachusetts, zip code number 02192. Now, you know, of course, that even if you're nowhere near that number and I draw your card, you're going to be rewarded with at least a couple of prizes. For example, today, when I draw a card, that person will win these prizes.
A Regina electric broom. No more vacuuming. From now on, it's electric brooming. With the deluxe three-speed Regina electric broom, makes cleaning a breeze, the ideal gift.
that somebody will win, because when they do, we always empty this out and start all over again. So for 450, somewhere near 738, this time, let's see, I'll go right down, way down in the middle here somewhere and pull one out. How's this? Good, it's large print. Easy to read. Okay, Paul W. Keeley, Post Office Box 311, Alston, Massachusetts. Anywhere between 728 and 748, his guess is 745. We have a winner. How about that? All right, $450. Now, $125 in the high-low jackpot, and it's all yours, Rich, if you knock them down. If not, we'll add $25 and do that every week till somebody walks away with whatever has accumulated. For $125 more. Okay, Charlie. No! Son of a gun. Why don't you get over here, and Rich, you stay right here now, please, because Rich, want to get on the other side of Charlie, and we also want to be sure that the folks at home get a chance to see you. Well, let's see how much money you did walk away with. You had a big, big week last week. Today, well, not bad. $300 for runner-up and $250 in bonus money.
I can deal with that.
Yeah, I bet you can, yeah. Okay. It's even better than bass fishing, isn't it?
Sometimes, yeah.
Sometimes, yeah. Okay, you get the smaller trophy. You can't come back again until the next show, huh?
That's right.
Oh, well, all right. Yeah. We'll see you again, yeah. I know. Okay. Congratulations, Rich.
Thank you.
Fourth time, you finally did it.
Yeah,
huh?
Finally.
That's wonderful. Okay, you get the big one, which you know. You're also going to get Florence Greenleaf's book on the history of Candlepin Bowling, but Phil Rubin's going to have to mail it to you. You couldn't find one today. And we have $1,850 for you. What a day, huh?
Good. Thanks a lot.
And you come back next week, too. You'll have a challenger, and if you win next week, then you'll have 2 months off while the ladies are on. You can go back again after the first of the year, okay?
Okay, thank you.
All right, congratulations to you. That's it. Don Gillis for the whole crew. We'll see you next week. Bye-bye, everybody.